habitats because of its negative impacts, and the fact that it is concentrated in nature makes it everyone's responsibility without discrimination. Government's commitment towards addressing the hydra-headed sanitation challenge facing the country is not in doubt at all. Mr. Chairperson, the NPP government, that any other government in the history of Ghana, is very much poised to tackle the sanitation challenge head-on. The remarkable achievements under the Greater Accra Metropolitan Area Sanitation and Water Project, with the key objective of increasing access to improved sanitation and water supply to low-income beneficiaries in Ghana, and improve the planning and management of environmental sanitation, is a clear demonstration of the acceleration required to improve sanitation in the sub-sector. The government project has constructed over 25,000 household toilets to benefit 200,000 low-income target population within an effective period of only 2 years. Ladies and gentlemen, the cumulative impact of government's efforts, coupled with all the development partners and stakeholders, has manifested recently in the recently released multiple indicator cluster survey, the mixed report of 2017-2018 by the Ghana Statistical Service. In this report, access to improved sanitation has increased from 15 to 21% nationally. Also, so much resources have been committed by our government and development partners to address the poor sanitation conditions in the country. The rate of improvement is still very slow. In Ghana, the water sector has three major agencies. The Water Resources Commission has the responsibility of surface water, groundwater, and management of river basins. The Ghana Water Company Limited is responsible for urban water and community, and Community Water and Sanitation Agency is responsible for facilitation of the rural water sector and some aspects of rural sanitation. Sanitation is the responsibility of the Metropolitan Municipal and District Assemblies. The Assemblies, in accordance with the Local Government Act 2016, Act 936, are responsible for all categories of infrastructure. Due to the technical nature of the engineering activities involved in these issues, there is the utmost need to set up national institutions to manage these specific activities. Sanitation is currently being handled by the Assemblies, and this has brought about the challenges being seen across the country today. The Ministry of Sanitation and Water Resources at the national level has a responsibility for policy formulation for the environmental sanitation sub-sector and to source funding for major infrastructure in the sector. The Ministry of Local Government and Rural Development has the oversight responsibility of the district assemblies who have the mandate for municipal services, including environmental sanitation. The Ministry of Environment, Science, Technology and Innovation is responsible for ensuring the environment is managed in the appropriate manner and provides the standards for operation of treatment and disposal sites. The Office of the Head of Local Government Service has responsibility for the recruitment and management of human resources for the district assemblies. There is an urgent need for a national body to take the overall responsibility of sanitation in Ghana. This national body will ensure that the required legal framework for the achievement of a cleaner and healthier environment is in place under one body. It will also ensure that all aspects of waste management and environmental sanitation are properly handled in a technical and professional manner. The National Sanitation Authority will be staffed with the relevant technical and professional staff have the required knowledge and training to handle the level challenges posed by the environmental sanitation management. Some of the key technical areas of the body will be handled include liquid waste management, solid waste, drain maintenance, storm water management, and monitoring and evaluation. The authority will also ensure there is capacity development of all relevant stakeholders. They will be responsible for research and development of cutting-edge technologies that can be incorporated in its operations. All aspects of the service chain, when it comes to both solid and liquid waste, will be part of the operations to ensure effective and efficient delivery of infrastructure and services. The National Sanitation Authority will have in place a sustainable and continuous flow of funds, which will ensure that services do not come to a halt. This can be achieved by setting up a fund with a percentage of the consolidated fund being provided for its operations. Mr. Chairman, preliminary activities on the establishment of the National Sanitation Authority and the National Sanitation Fund has already been undertaken by the Ministry in collaboration with some stakeholders, which need to be fine-tuned. Some of these preliminary activities which have already been undertaken include a proposed structure of the National Sanitation Authority and the National Sanitation Fund, which has been hinted here, staffing for the National Sanitation Authority and then the National Sanitation Fund, and then sources of funding for the National Sanitation Authority and then the National Sanitation Fund, and then the geographical location of the NSA and the NSF offices and ancillary infrastructure. These have also been highlighted here. Mr. Chairman, the onus is now on us to realign our NSA and NSF with government's policies, and at the same time, redesign it in such a way that its power and authority will not be compromised in order to achieve the needed change in sanitation. Mr. Chairman, let me extend a general invitation to the development partners, NGOs, and all stakeholders, particularly the media, that their suggestions and inputs are most needed at this stage of the development of the National Sanitation Authority to make it a success. Thank you very much, and God bless us all.